56 years, the time has finally come. Say goodbye to an old friend.
Good evening. 16,000 fans join the Sabres in saying goodbye to the odds. Thanks for watching. The big story tonight, it's an end of an era. The Buffalo Sabres have played their final game at Memorial Auditorium, and they went out with a win. Night Team's Mary Murray joins us live from the Odd now with more on tonight's final farewell. Mary?
Melissa, what a ceremony it was. You know, the final puck has been dropped here at Center Ice. The Sabres have a new home, as a packed house said their final farewell. There's no place like home, and more than 16,000 Sabres fans couldn't wait to visit their team's home, Memorial Auditorium, for the final time. With keepsake tickets in hand and extra security on deck, many fans stepped into the building and into a new era of hockey in Buffalo.
I come down to a lot of the games, and this is a kind of a building that you feel so much at home in, because every seat you have is home. And we've sat all over this building for so many years.
Of the night was the lowering of the Sabres banners. It appeared to make the team's move to the Marine Midland Arena really hit home.
I've been going to this auditorium for 45 years about, ever since I've been a kid. Bison hockey game, Canisius College basketball games, you know, the whole works. I'm sorry to see it go, but I'm looking forward to a new building.
Number 10, Cranland.
There were plenty of former Sabres stars on hand to usher in the new era, including members of the French Connection, Rick Martin and Rene Robert. And for some fans, it's famous players like that made the odd, well, the odd.
I have been a Sabre fan ever since Tim Horton came here. And when Brad got drafted, he got my team, so I am thrilled. And it is, it's a sad night to see it go, but it's going to be extremely happy when it starts with the new arena.
The night was filled with a lot of poignant memories, and for some fans, they want to hold on to those memories forever.
And I want to catch every step of the way. I've been a season ticket holder now for 5 years. My parents were season ticket holders since the early 70s, and we took the familiar trek, had the camera in the car all the way down. And
there's certainly some bittersweet moments here at the Odd, and as I look around and see all the empty seats, it really brings home that this is indeed the last game the Sabres will play here at Memorial Auditorium. Miles?
Yeah, I think a lot of people like myself going to miss that nosebleed section. Of course, the oranges.
Oh, absolutely. You know, and as you spoke with fans, in my piece, you know, they were happy, they were sad, they were in between. But I should say, now, the Odd is still open for a couple things. There's going to be a graduation, there's going to be an ice show, and even a wrestling show. But as far as professional hockey, that's it here at Memorial Auditorium.
All right, and on to the Marine Midland Arena.
Bigger and better things, Miles.
All right, thanks a lot, Mary, for that live report. Some hearts were heavy tonight with the final game being played at the Odd. And as News 4's Craig Negrelli tells us, it's still not clear what the future holds for the old arena.
Enjoy the game, fellas.
We will.
Peter DeSabio Sr. was at his trademark post pouring drinks at what is known as the Poor Man's Odd Club for the final time. Peter's been serving fans for 26 years, and as you can imagine, he has fond memories of some special moments at the Odd.
I'll never forget the fog night.
Air going after it, he scores!
I'll never forget the four overtimes.
Ironically, Peter was donning a T-shirt with the new Sabres logo this afternoon as he proudly displayed an old picture taken at the Odd.
This was taken in the early 70s when Joe Byron was a fellow who used to sing the national anthem. This is myself. This is Joe Byron, and this is another fellow employee, my bartender. His name is Carl.
Those memories will live on as the Sabres move on to the new Marine Midland Arena. As for what will happen to this place, most simply referred to as the Odd, well, that's still up in the air.
We're in the preliminary stages of putting together our waterfront plan, and I think a lot of that will be really the impetus to come up with some great ideas to use the auditorium or that site in the future.
But Mayor Masiello says he, too, will miss the Odd. Today, he showed me pictures of when he played basketball there.
I was always driving to the hoop. I like to score. People say there's no shots left in my arm. I took so many when I was a kid, you know.
And the Odd was filled at those.
The Odd, every Saturday night, Craig, there'd be 10,000 to 12,000 people. That's what it said at the time. And that was the night out.
And in the late 60s, programs were just a quarter.
I made the All-Star team, which was a great honor.
As the mayor put it, you have to grow and, unfortunately, leave behind beautiful places, but certainly not the memories. Craig Negrelli, News 4, Tonight.